noticed our man feel that he is more important to them than he is to us. We don't believe that at all. So we're very pleased that Andrew's come all the way down, and Andrew is going to look after things here. Now, before I hand over to Katie, then, just one little bit of sad news to pass on, but to implore your prayers for as well. One of our number has been rushed into hospital this evening, and you know we always pass on that sort of information so that it can be a matter of concern and prayer without interfering with all these celebrations that we share. And certainly Brian wouldn't want that. Those who know Brian Holt from Carlisle, he's been taken to hospital, and we'll know a little bit more tomorrow when they do some more tests. But his name is Brian, he comes from Carlisle. If you mention Brian in your prayers tonight, that would be much appreciated. Thank you very much. Over to you, Katie. Here's the mic for you. Welcome.
Good evening.
Good evening.
We're going to try and squeeze on here while sole survivors are packing away. But I'm sure we'll sell
it. Have you had a good day? Do you know, I'm getting really sad now because we've only got one day left, haven't we? Oh, who's looking forward to going home? Said the other day, if you want to front these every week, you have to come to any Garden City. Okay, so it's good to see you all. We're growing, we want more people, so come to any Garden City. And you can have front these every week.
Time
we have left together, and we're going to have a great night today praising God. And Psalm 150 says, praise the Lord, praise God in his sanctuary, praise him in his mighty heavens, praise him for his acts of power, praise him for his surpassing greatness, praise him with the sounding of the trumpets, praise him with the harp and lyre, praise him with tambourine and dancing. Praise him with the strings and flutes. Praise him with the clash of cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. We've got the trumpets, we've got the tambourines, we've got the dancing, we've got the strings, and we've got the cymbals. So let us stand and praise God.
We just need to do one thing. Everyone needs to stand up. Now, this is a song, I don't know if you know it, it's got some actions, okay? And they've got to be done properly. So we're going to sing the song, Praise Him on the Trumpet. Yeah? Okay? Now, you can do whatever you want for the verses. It's a bit of a free-for-all. You want to come and dance at the front, okay? But this is how the chorus goes. We're going to go, Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. And then you can just do your own little thing. And then we'll do it again, the other way. And with our arms up. Do you think you can manage that? It's not too strenuous for last night, is it? I don't think, no. Okay, let's sing it. Let's enjoy it.
Praise him on the love of sin, Lord. Praise him on the love.
I don't think I've got much left now. It's only about some.
We have our daily challenge winner. Have they been more difficult this year? Have they been too difficult? Blankie. Okay. I think that's why he's winning the lunch table.
I think he deserves it.
Vote for Keith. Keith Turton is the name to go for the guns tank. Okay, so we have a joint winner.
Ooh.
Because it's two people that have done it together.
And you have to share the book then.
You have to share the book.
No, you get another
book. No, it's the same people. Oh no, it's not the same people.
It's a couple.
They're a couple.
They can share the book.
It's A. Holland's. Oh, Catherine's getting two books. Isn't she lovely?
There's a drum roll going here.
Drum roll. It's A. Holland and B. Jackson.
Yeah.
From E. Grade 20.
Oh, I see some waves. They haven't gone to bed again, have they?
Yeah, we
have. Oh, you were here. Oh, you want us to bring it to you?
Oh, dear. Make this work.
Tell you what, you can tell it's the end of the week, can't you?
We have two great books here. We have Lasting Joyce. And we also have Ships of Mercy, and it looks like it's about the Mercy Ships. Now Michael has lots to do with Mercy Ships, because one of my soldiers has done much work with them, and he spends more time with them than he does with us. I don't think he likes
us. Well done. The next song we've got tonight is a request, and it's a request and it's attributed to Philip, Monica and Paulie. And I love this song, I think it's a brilliant rousing song. And the song is, O God of Burning Cleansing Flames, Send the Fire. I know we're quite hot this evening, it's difficult to think about sending fire, but it's a different kind of fire. So let's sing it with as much gusto as we can.
Girls in there as well.
No, I don't think we do.
Shall we see?
Yeah.
Does that mean I'm...
Oh, here we go. We've got a drum roll, drum roll, we've got a drum roll. Here we go again. And who's the other one? Mel Hart. Where's lovely Mel? Is he around? Here he is. Right, what I need to hear, so I know who's voting, you've got 30 seconds, and you've got 30 seconds to tell us why you shouldn't be lunched. Okay? And this is to try and persuade us, okay? And see if it works. Are you ready for that, boys? You've got 30 seconds.
Well, I want my £20 back for the amount that I voted for you. I just need to say, you good people have consciences. And I know that you will not allow me to be gunned tomorrow evening. Because if you do, if you're that type of people, I just want to know you.
The drama queen extraordinaire starts in. Who's next?
John Jim!
Keith wants it. Keith deserves it. My mum is going to be very upset if it's me. And remember, friends, look at the screen. You've done this to me before.
Oh, that was a good sign.
Do you want to see that again? You've done it to me before. Don't do it again.
Mark.
Well, I think there's no competition really, so it's Keith. He's got to win. I thought everybody loved me, and obviously they don't, because even my own mum voted for me to be dumped.
See, my mum refuses to vote for me.
She's the only one not voting for you, looking at those votes.
I remain Pat. From Tunbridge Wells, it's all Pat's fault.
Okay, get off the stage. They've made their pleas, it's your decision. You can't transfer your votes, no, sorry. They've made their pleas, it's in your hands. If you want to vote for the final day to see who's going to be gunged tomorrow night, vote Keith. All right.
Keith.
Mr. Turner.
Okay, what do we have next?
Well, we've got another request next.
A request from Ipswich Bradford Road for... And they want to sing He came to give us life. Amen. Came to give us life in its fullness.
Thank you.
set us free because he loved us. For God so loved the world that he gave his son. And there's a song that is, "My Jesus, I love thee. I love thee because you first loved me. I love you because you came and you loved me so much that you were willing to give your son for us." And that's the love that we celebrate this evening. And we're going to sing "My Jesus, I love thee" when the band have got their breath back, I think.
restless heart be so imperfectly. But when you come and I am filled with wonder, it's then I think I glimpse eternity.
over the years, is it? Is it a week? Fear? Okay, a few people, that's not bad. Well, we've got Gordon over here, and I've already given my order in. So if you're new, you might not know this, but Gordon makes videos of the week, and he films everything, and you can choose. If there are some days you thought, oh, that day was a bit dodgy, don't really want that day, you don't have to tick that day, you can have the videos you want. And he said he did a 48 order last year and had them all done, delivered by Christmas. So you want a Christmas present, be a Christmas present or something, or maybe you just want them for yourself, that's fine. He did over 2,000 texts last year. So if you want any texting, stand up, Gordon, so everyone can see you. Oh, you know Gordon, he sang tonight.
Didn't he do well?
In 6 years. Oh, in 6 years,
it was done
every 2000. Sorry
about that. Can I say I had some of Gordon's tapes last year, and they have given my friends and family great humour and great laughter. Not because I've been videoing, but because what was videoed.
So if you need to give him an order form, you can't just say, Gordon, make me a tape. You need to give him a form, so go to him to get one if you want. It needs to be done before you go home. For tomorrow night, yeah, and he'll have them sorted for you. Cheers, Gordon.
I recommend it. Give you great memories of this wonderful week. Do you know, God's love is so amazing, isn't it? It just goes beyond my understanding, and I think, how can God possibly love me? And the next song is, have you ever stopped to really think about how God loves you? It sounds quite incredible, but it is true. Nothing on the earth or in the heavens above is as sure and certain as God's love. And there's actually the chorus of this. It's as high as the sky, it's as deep as the sea, it's as wide as God's love is for you and for me. So when we hide from his love is everywhere. Okay.
I'm going to put the mic down for this one.
Oh,
I love song for tonight. It's one of my favourites because the words say so much. The words are personal because it talks about what Jesus has done for me, me as an individual. It says, thank you for saving me. Saving me, what else can I say? You are my everything. I will sing your praise. It says, you shed your blood for me. Jesus went to the cross and shed his blood for me because he loves me so much. And when he went to that cross, he took my sin. He took my shame. A sinner called by name. And then the chorus says, great is the Lord, for we know your truth has set us free. And it's the last verse that really speaks to me. The last line of this chorus, because it says, you've set your hope in me. And I just find that line amazing, because I think of my life, I think of those dreadful things I've done, those dreadful things I still do every day, those bad things that we say, those bad things that we do. But despite that, Jesus went to the cross because of that, because he loves me, so he could take my sin and my shame. And what's so incredible, that he sees me, he sees potential in me. He spoke about potential last night. Jesus looks at my life and he sets his hope in me. And I just find that mind-blowing that he went to the cross for me, for each and every one of us, and set his hope in us. Eternity with you. We just thank you for your love, Lord. We thank you for the love that we feel tonight. We thank you for your Holy Spirit's presence upon us. Father, we pray for Ian now as he comes to you, comes to us with your word. We pray that you'll give him the words to him you want us to hear, and just inspire him, Father God, to take us deeper with you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Joined, well, joined the team. See if you remember these names, Major Ray Begley, yeah. Ray, and Major Val Milchrist, yeah. Tracy Val, Major Jim Williams, yeah. Yeah. Sam Nicky, and she came Sam Turner after, didn't she? Wesley Carroll played the piano, yeah. Yeah. There was Sue Blythe, wasn't it? There was Joe Schultz. All these different people, Melvin Letts, James Lawrence, yeah, Richard Carroll. Well, I'll tell you what, it's going to be Andy Glennis, Glennis Hines. Well, I've talked in memory of another two things. You know, we've had some fantastic times at the Horizons. And all these great times have been whilst we've been in the presence of God, isn't it? And I just wonder, at this moment in time, what's your relationship with God like this particular moment? And yeah, you're a little bit like me and realise that it could be better. Things are not perhaps as we would like them to be, it could be better. You know, some of us have been Christians for a long time now, haven't we? And we've been drudging away, you know, treading the road for a very long time. And I wonder whether or not we've been relying on memory a little bit of what the things that Jesus taught us, whether we actually rely on our upbringing, or whether every day, you know, fresh every day, we gain a new relationship with our Creator. I just wonder, you know, as well, whether or not our memories, you know, sometimes play tricks on us as well, you know, and we think that we know about God, and really, you know, we are living perhaps off our predecessors' faith, off our parents' faith. And I wonder what our communion, right, our communication, our divine communion with God, our Creator, is really like. Because there are occasions when we become complacent, isn't it? I think if we were to have a little bit of a spiritual check now, there's times where we would become a little bit complacent with our lives, and we need a bit of a memory jogger to bring to our mind the blessings that we have received when we've been living in harmony with our Creator. And also, you know, how these blessings came about. Well, I've asked the band to play a piece of music called Divine Communion. This is a real old piece of music, published just at the end of the Second World War, written by an Australian bandmaster called Arthur Gullidge. Now, he died in captivity as a Japanese prisoner of war. But his music, he left a real legacy to us. And this particular selection of songs, they actually describe development and progression of a Christian that results in a divine communion with our Creator. The music is split into three sections. First section tells us of the sacrificial offering of our lives. There's a song which I'm sure David Jones and Bruce Ian tell us what number it was in James 5 called All There Is of Me, Lord. Basically an offering of self. The second section, okay, is a prayer, it's a continuous prayer. Every day of life, I think we should be praying. The sweet will of God still fold me closer till I am wholly lost in thee. Now, this beautiful music, and it is real beautiful music, continues to play and describes the pleasure of being lost in the presence of God and us enjoying that time with Him. And thirdly then, music brings to us the recognition of the need for the Holy Spirit to be our Creator, be our guide, our counselor. And a very old source of song called Holy Spirit, Faithful God. You know, this wonderful, communicative piece of music fills in a real, tranquil, peaceful manner which encompasses a life in a divine communion with the whole presence of God. And some of this is what's there, Kevin. The next time they come
to you.
you, Grant. Thank you, Kevin. Do you remember now, you know, the blessings that you've had when you've been lost in the presence of God? Can you remember those? To live in a life just pleasing with God isn't always easy, is it? We sometimes need a bit of a nudge on occasions to remember, you know, the teaching of Jesus when we find ourselves in a particular situation. Just to remember, you know, what would Jesus do in this situation? How would he act? How would he behave? You know, for us to actually be the person that God originally created us to be. When we find ourselves in a community, you know, to be a Christian, to be light in a dark, dark world. And Jesus taught us so many things, you know, all recorded in the Word, in the Bible. And this is how John recorded some of Jesus' last words. This is the paraphrase of the message, and it's a couple of words from John chapter 14. This is what Jesus said. He said, "The friend, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send at my request, will make everything plain to you. The Holy Spirit will remind you of all the things I have told you. I'm leaving you well and whole. That's my parting gift to you. Peace. I don't leave you the way you used to be left, feeling abandoned and bereft. So don't be upset. Don't be distraught. Peace will leave us." We're going to sing our benediction tonight. And I'm just going to ask if you will consider yourselves in this noise, okay? Consider the peace that Jesus has offered to you this evening and offered to you every day. And I'm going to ask whether or not, you know, you're willing to accept this peace, because quite often we want to go about things in our own way, don't we? Let us just pray together. Father God, tonight we thank you. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for your Holy Spirit, who continues to remind us of the love you have for us. No, Lord, during tough times, I ask that you continue to remind us of the blessings, of the pleasures of being with you. And when we don't consider you, Father, just remind us again of Jesus. Remind us of the peace that you continually offer to each of us. And help us, Father, teach us to be able to receive from you, Lord. Lord, keep our minds set on you. Thank you for the gift of your Son. Thank you for your peace. Thank you for good memories, Lord. Thank you for Jesus. Amen. Let's sing our benediction together.